Now in one, Claire learns there's a method to Robin's madness while she's forced to obey her jailer on Shortland Street.
You like it?
You can't do this. Move yourself into our basement.
Oh, no, 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 honey. It's not me moving in here. It's you.
How is this going to get you, Andrew? He'll think you're such a psycho.
I know this plan's going to work.
Where's Claire?
What?
Stop messing with me. She's meant to be staying with me, and I've been up half the night worrying about her.
I haven't seen or heard from her.
I don't want to hurt you. It's just that you got all hysterical on me, and I... Are you going to slash me in the face?
I'm serious, Robin. I will do it.
And I'm saying go for it.
We're really fighting.
We're only fooling around.
I've seen alley cats behave better. And then there's your father's test results. I'd be beside myself.
You said last night that you weren't worried.
Of course they are. And whose fault do you think that is?
Well, if you hadn't been so down about
that. That is enough. Can't you two knock it off for 5 minutes? Your father is up there doing his level best to keep it together. And the least he can expect from the two of you is a bit of support.
I'm telling you one more time, if you don't mind...
And I am telling you that the only way you are going to get out of here is by doing what you threatened to. Honestly, Claire, you could have had someone's eye out with that.
Why don't you just let me go home?
Oh, what home? You don't even have one. Oh, don't start crying, for God's sake. For someone who thinks she's so tough, you didn't even have the guts to do what it takes to get yourself out of here.
How much longer is this going to go on for?
Well, that very much depends on Jake.
What?
Well, it depends on how long he takes to sound the alarm. Sadly, he doesn't appear to be in too much of a hurry.
That's not true. Jake loves me. If he knew I was down here, then he'd do anything to get me out.
Yeah, well, he doesn't need to do anything. He just needs to call Sarah, get her back here and get her out of my way. I mean, so far he hasn't even started looking for you.
Even if Jake does bring Sarah here, I don't see how that would help you.
Well, all I need is a little time alone with Andrew. Then I'll come back here and discover you've accidentally locked yourself in the basement and voila, I'm the hero again.
And what's to stop me from telling Andrew what actually happened?
With your excellent track record with the truth, he'll never believe you. Oh, I've brought you down here, locked you in against your will. It's too far-fetched. Anyway, you've been lying about Jake for weeks. And look, here's the proof, your own little basement love nest.
Well, well, fancy seeing you three again. I should get sick more often.
Oh, that's not funny, love.
Oh, it's a little bit funny, isn't it?
Has the neurologist shown up yet?
Dr. Valentine's just gone to give him a hurry up.
We'll be okay. Whatever comes back.
Yeah, of course we will.
We'll be with you all the way, Dad.
That's right.
This is us.
This is us.
Guess we better get it over with then.
I guess so.
You better be right about this, for Dad's sake.
Hi.
Hi, you ready?
He's just finding his favourite beer.
Mr. Cuddly, he's at my place.
Oh, no, Mr. Cuddly saw last week. This week it's Dr. Snuffles.
Oh?
He won't be long. He's been talking about going to your place all day.
You mean our place, the marital home?
Did you hear about Claire?
I heard she ran away. Guess it all got too much for her and she took off.
Chris, we've been through
this. Yeah, we have. Come on, Harry. Oh, and this is Dr. Snuffles, is it? I take this as Dr. Snuffles.
Yeah, that's him. He's your favourite, isn't he?
Yeah, we're going to go to the big house now, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
All right, you be good for Daddy, do what he says.
Oh, I missed you. Oh, we're going to have some fun, aren't we, eh? We're going to have a good time. I'll see you tomorrow.
See ya.
Thank you, Doctor.
Good luck. Thanks, mate.
So, you won't have me pushing around in a wheelchair after all?
Well, we can't be sure about that, can we?
That's true. But even if it should happen, it shouldn't be for a long time. The outlook with Kennedy's disease is much better than it is with motor neurone disease.
I can't believe they put Dad through all of that.
No, it's not a good look. You did very well to pick it up.
Our baby nurse came through for us.
There's our girl.
I guess Tanya and I should make an appointment with the Jenny Six counsellor.
The neurologist will look after all that.
Right.
Hey, I know it's a lot to take in.
How are you two doing? You all right?
The main thing is you've been given a lifeboat without holes. That's all that matters.
But there isn't any point in thinking of the downside until we've talked to that genetics chap, is that right?
He'll be able to give all the details about any inherited factors. But in the meantime, it seems to me like you've all got something to celebrate.
Like being able to stick around to keep an eye on these two for a bit longer.
You have a listen. You can be Dr. Harry. Can you hear anything? Well, that's a relief.
Knock, knock.
Who are you? What can I do for you?
Sorry to interrupt. I've got that report on discharge delays I mentioned.
Yep, throw it in the pile. I'll have a look at it tonight.
This must be the new plastics registrant. They get younger every year.
This is Harry. Harry, say hello to Miss Samuel.
Hello.
Hello. You having fun with your dad?
Yes.
I'll let you get back to it.
By the way, had a call this morning from Jenny, from the DHB.
Oh.
Yes, Stephen Law has been moved sideways. He's not in charge of negotiating contracts anymore. So, if Mrs. Law wanted to give the board a good shake-up, seems she's got her wish.
I guess so.
And you get to keep your job.
Seems I got lucky.
I'd say so.
Is this a bad time?
I was just leaving.
Cannot get a handle on that woman.
Well, you're going to have a lot more opportunity to try. I've just told her her job here is secure.
What do you think of it?
Jury's out. I can't decide whether or not to trust her.
Yeah, well, she didn't have a great introduction to the place.
That's an understatement.
Still, she's got to be a lot more fun than Nick was, I suppose.
So what did you want to see me about?
I was going to ask you out for a beer, but I can see you've got company.
Yep, me and Harry are having a boys' night in tonight, aren't we, Harry? Yeah, and we're going to have so much fun, I might not give him back.
How's it going?
Part of me still thinks there's hope, but...
He's got to hang in there, I guess.
I guess so. All right, now it's my turn. Let's have a listen. Oh, my goodness.
I can't hear a thing.
You can't hear a thing? Oh, my goodness. I hope you're all right. Here we are.
I owe you a major apology. Turns out you're right about Dad.
I didn't count on it being such a mixed blessing.
Well, the main thing is that Dad's
gonna... Gonna be okay, yeah, I know. But I am your sister, and if you can't whine to me about how much this Kennedy's thing sucks, who can you whine to?
Well, it's not just me. Presumably you're going to want to have kids one day. And Libby?
Maybe. But it's not exactly on the top of my priority list at the moment. Not like you.
Having a baby is really all I've been thinking about lately.
I know.
Now I'm carrying this disease. I couldn't put my baby through what Dad's going through.
They might not get it.
Well, there's a 50% chance they will.
The odds do suck.
Better off playing Russian roulette.
Like Craig said, we'll just wait until we've seen the genetic specialist, okay, and get all the facts before we start talking Russian roulette.
I know. Here I was going on about finding the perfect healthy sperm donor. Turns out I'm the one with the problem.